thinking. So here in Surat al-Zumar talks about how the false things, you know, Zumar talks about how the delegation, like, you know, group of people, they go to Jannah, and a group of people, they go to Jahannam. They will be dragged, and the people who are dragged to Jannah and the people who are dragged to Jahannam. So here talks about that. And also in Surat al-Zumar we see how the juz begins, and Zumar, the powerful chapter, Allah describes a vivid scene in which humanity has been judged and stand in two groups, believers and disbelievers. The ultimate end of both groups is described in detail and end with an amazing scene in which the believers enter through gates of Jannah and witness the angels surrounding the throne of Allah, and they are saying salam and they are welcoming. And in this place, the faith rewarded, it will be said all praises to Allah, the Lord of the world. And the next surah, Suratul Ghafir. Suratul Ghafir is forgiver. Allah describes a believer who lives in the house of Pharaoh and tries to persuade his people, not oppose Musa. There are two more recurring themes in this surah, disputing Allah's truth and calling on him. And finally, Suratul Fussilat in detail continues the theme of Tawheed, Quran Tawheed, unity and resurrection. In juz number 24, Suratul Zumar continues 32 till end, and Suratul Ghafir and Suratul Fussilat. So here we see Suratul Zumar, false ideologies, speaking or thinking about Allah, those things which he is not is a lie. And one who does that, that is the greatest wrongdoer, disbelieving, associating partner with Allah, and atheism, all are beliefs based on false ideologies. It is necessary to avoid them. Who is Muttaqi? Allah's consciousness, a caller of truth who brought the truth and verifies the truth is Muttaqi. For them is what they will wish. Allah is sufficient. حسبي الله عليه يتوكل المتوكلون. Allah is sufficient for his servant against every enemy of his truth. حسبي الله عليه توكل. Allah is sufficient for me. On him do the reliant rely. Sleep, a sister of death. Sleeping every day, then waking up is an evidence for death. No one is able to stop sleep, and no one will be able to stop death. And here, test of knowledge. Considering blessings not as a favor of Allah, rather considering it is an accomplishment of one's knowledge is a big test. And that's what Harun said, I am given this because of my knowledge, because of my skill set. No, Allah has given us an ayah full of hope. Even the greatest sinner does not need to despair from the mercy, rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, turns towards him and be obedient, then he will forgive him. In Allah, yaghfiru zunuba jamia. Indeed, Allah forgives all the sins, regrets. There will only be regret and sorrow tomorrow if one does not leave the addiction of sin and changes the lifestyle today. Wastage of the deeds. All the deeds will be wasted if one does not leave shirk. Shirk is not give Allah his due rights. And shirk is zulmun azim. Then talks about nufiqa fasa'iqa al-qiyam. Nufiqa blown. Fasa'iqa, then he fainted. Qiyam, stand up. Everyone will faint when the first blow. While the second blow, they will stand and start staring. The distance between two blows will be 40. Only Allah knows about the 40, whether it will be days, months or years. Then the plane of judgment. Earth will be shining with the light of Rabb. Book of deeds will be placed. Prophets and witnesses will be brought. Judgment will be done with justice. Nobody will be wronged. every soul will be fully recompensed. And people in groups, people will be driven in groups, Zumara, according to the interest in ideologies. The keeper of hellfire will ask about the coming of messengers, while keepers, Khazanatuha, of paradise will say, welcome, salamun, tibtum, with peace. And attributes of Allah, Ghafir and Zambi, Ghafir is Zam, the forgiver of sins. Qabil al-Tawb, the acceptor of repentance. Shadid al-Iqab, the stern in punishment. Zid Tawl, possessor of the bounty. La ilaha illahu, no deity worthy of worship except him. Supplication of those who carry the throne. Rabbana wasi'ata kulla shay'in rahmatan wa ilman faghfir lil lazina tabu wattabu sabilaka wa qim azab al jahim. O our Rabb, you encompassed everything in mercy and knowledge, so forgive those who repented and follow your way and save them from the torment of hellfire. Rabbana adkhilhum jannati adnin التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم إنك أنت العزيز الحكيم بخيم السيئات ومن تخ السيئات يومئذ فقد رحمته وذلك هو الفوز العظيم. So this is, O our Rabb, enter them in gardens of eternity which you promised them, and whoever was righteous from their forefathers and their spouse, and indeed you are always almighty and always wise, and save them from sins, and whoever saves from sin, that day in fact you bestowed mercy on him. Yawm al-Zafir. The Yawm al-Azifa, Yawm al-Azifa, day that is nearing, Azifa, the day of judgment, when the hearts will leap to the throat. Wrongdoers will neither have a friend nor an intercessor. Supplication for seeking protection from an enemy of the true. Inni uztu bi rabbi wa rabbikum min kulli mutakabbirin la yuminu bi yawmil hisab. Indeed, I have sought refuge with my Rabb and your Rabb from every arrogant who does not believe in day of accountability. Believing men, he was one from the people of Pharaoh. He drew attention to his people by being thoughtful of the hereafter, by warning from the punishment of Allah. Sabil al-Rashad, the right guidance, to consider this world a temporary place and hereafter permanent place, right guidance. Punishment of grave, it is a fact. People of Pharaoh are presented before fire of hell in their graves morning and evening. Supplication, it's a prayer, so one should ask from Allah only. He is the one who answers all prayers. People of Samud, they prefer being blind instead of accepting guidance with their eyes wide open when the punishment of thunderbolt sees them. Do not listen to Quran. Tactic of disbelievers is to not to let listen to Quran and to lower its effect by music and making noises. These days also you have noticed people avoid by making music sound more loud, more louder and louder. Allah is my Rabb. Those who say this is and stay firm on it, they will be supported by angels who will give them glad tidings and enter Jannah. So this was the juz number 24. So here we see faman azlamu, who is more unjust, and mimman, whoever, kazaba alallahi, they lie, and those who are kazaba and those who were like, you know, lying, and for them Allah says alaysa fi jahannam maswal lil kafirin. Hellfire is enough for the people who deny, because that is the permanent residence for them. But as for the wallazi ja'a bisidqi, for the one who the truth came and they believe, for the they abide with the truth, for them ulaika humul muttaqun, those are the people who are muttaqun. Who are muttaqun? They have Allah's fear and they do obedience towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they don't do disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those are the muttaqun, because they have taqwa. And we learn this dua, inni ustu bi rabbi wa rabbikum min kulli mutakabbirin la yuminu biyawmil hisab. We don't want to be among the mutakabbir. And also there is another dua we learn, Allahumma ahsi aqibatina fil umuri kulliha wa ajirna min khizyud dunya wa zabil akhirah. And here we learn who is holding the arsh of Allah, throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what they are doing, allazina yahmilul arsha wa man hawlahu, and they are surrounded around the throne. And what they are doing, yusabbihuna bihamdi rabbihim, they are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa yuminuna bihi wa yastaghfiru lillazina, and they do istighfar for the people who believe. But what are the key things we have to do? Rabbana wasi'at kulla shay'in rahmatan wa ilma faghfir lillazina tabu. We should do tabu, we should do tawbah, and wattabu sabilika wa qim azab al jahim, and they will be averted from the azab al jahim, safe from the hellfire. But we should ask tawbah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do istighfar more than 70 times, 100 times, so we should do more than 70 times. And Allahumma inni as'alukal jannatul firdaus, ask the best of the best jannah, that is jannatul firdaus. Al-qalqu samawati wal ard, sky and the earth, akbaru min qalqin nas, and Allah is the one who created everything. Innal ladhina qalu rabbuna Allah summa istaqamu tatanazzalu alayhim malaika, do the istiqama and complete firmness. And there is a saa, there will be a day, about there is no doubt, but the people who are disbelievers, la raiba fiha, but walakinna, most of them, aksar an nasi la yuminun, but they don't believe in the saa, about the qiyama, that will completely, there is no doubt it will come, but they deny it, because they don't believe in it, disbelievers. And Allah will answer the prayer, but the people who are not their slaves, they will don't believe in it, and they will enter to Jahannam. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, those who deny what they do, لَا تَسْمَعُوا, when they listen to Quran, لِحَازَ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَّغُوا فِيهِ, and they are heedless about Quran, they don't listen to Quran, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ, and they won't be able to overcome with that, because they are surrounded with the things which are not useful, they are surrounded with this worldly things which is not beneficial for the hereafter. So today's juzu we learn about, do not despair the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah can forgive all the sins. And also we learn which party will you be in on the day of judgment, believers or disbelievers, in Surah Az-Zumar. The people who are given honor in the Jannah, and they were asked to enter Jannah, whereas the people of Jahannam, they were literally dragged, siha. And the good tidings for the people who are believers, angels are making for them forgiveness, but we should also ask forgiveness, and on behalf of us, then they will ask for forgiveness. And do not get despair of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the severe punishment who rejected Allah's signs, and the many blessings of Allah and Quran, and the condition of those who rejected, the danger of having evil companions, and the fact that they make disbelief and sin alluring. So we have to check ourselves, in whose company we are. Our friend, they inspire us, or we inspire them. We want righteous company. Even Anbiya Ikram, they want righteous company. So do we. The importance of calling to Allah and having good manners, looking to the horizon.